Pierce County looks at a project in the Lincoln District to save money while also helping South Sound 911 and the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department. We'll examine the cost, what it means for the neighborhood, and common questions from public meetings, such as what makes this proposal different, why does the health department need a new building, and why is this the perfect location for a police and fire call center? Those answers and more right now on Pierce County Talks. An opportunity and a location has become available that would save Pierce County money by moving one of its departments out of an expensive lease, while also helping South Sound 911 and the Health Department. First, PCTV's Megan Hutton explains the county's proposal and how the agencies would work together.
911, what are you reporting?
South Sound 911 is looking for a site to build its new Emergency Operations Center for Police and Fire. And one of the few good locations is some county land in Tacoma's Lincoln District. The county is exploring the idea of selling the land where the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and the Soundview building now sit to South Sound 911, where it can demolish and build its new operations. The county would buy an office building across the street next to the medical examiner's office for both departments.
We're talking about purchasing an existing building rather than us building a building to put agencies in, so that's a big step forward. It's not an attempt to consolidate everything in the county into one building. The health department and the community connections, they have some real synergy where it makes sense for them to be together, and it does have the ability to get us out of at least one lease.
One of the benefits is having them co-located with community connections. There is a lot of overlap between the type of services, the clientele, that both deal with a lot of social services.
The county plans to hold a series of public meetings to explore the idea further.
To have all stakeholders talk about why this is good for South Sound 911, for the city of Tacoma, for the health department, and for the county. So you've got all four entities saying that this has a lot of merit, so we want to take it out and get some feedback from folks.
South Sound 911 already has the funding to buy the property, and Pierce County would put that revenue toward the newer office building, issuing a bond to cover the remainder.
I think residents will be very happy that we purchased the building, an existing building, made the tenant improvements, and I think the price tag will be very reasonable to do that. South Sound 911, voters already approved the 0.1%, so it's already had a vote of the people to say yes, construct the building.
The plan also calls for demolishing the vacant, dilapidated Puget Sound Hospital, which has attracted crime and squatters to the neighborhood.
And I think the people that will be most interested will be the folks that live in the Lincoln District. The city of Tacoma is investing over $4 million in some development in that area of the city. And so I think there's many opportunities for us to do some synergistic things with this development along with what the city's doing.
Learn more about the idea online at piercecountywa.org/HCB.
The health and community building proposal has many moving parts, multiple agencies, and a lot of details that we're going to dive into today. Joining me now to talk about the plan is Pierce County Council Member and Board of Health Vice Chair Rick Talbert and Construction Project Manager Travis Wakefield with Pierce County Facilities Management. Welcome to you both.
Thanks. Thanks.
So let's talk about the complexity of this issue. It is a complex issue. Travis, what's the simplest explanation?
I think the simplest explanation is it's two separate projects, and they're related by the location of the two separate projects. One is a relocation project that is purchasing an existing building across the street, relocating the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections into that building. And by doing that relocation project, it makes the current buildings and sites they occupy vacant. And then that site is available for the South Sound 911 to develop their facility. So simply it's two separate projects related by their location, and one is dependent on the other. So the health and community building needs to happen in order for the South Sound 911 project to proceed.
And Rick, regarding the health and community building, what's the relationship between Pierce County and the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department?
So the health department is currently in a facility that's 40 years old and quite frankly is not in the best condition, first of all, or the best situated for the functions of the health department. And statutorily, health departments are a function of county government. We have a unique relationship in Pierce County in that we partner with the city of Tacoma. And so we have the best of both worlds in that we have this incredible partner. But at the end of the day, it's the county that's responsible for health department functions and health department facilities. And so we need to, and we've known for a while that we're going to need new facilities for the health department, either a separate building, a new building, or expensive remodel of the existing facilities. So the situation that exists now with this relationship with the South Sound 911 building allows us to not only address our issues with regards to the health department, but also assist in South Sound 911 and have economy of scale and be able to put together a project that saves both the county and South Sound 911.
Speaking of South Sound 911, tell me a little bit how they fit into the relationship between Pierce County and the health department, the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department.
Well, South Sound 911 is its own agency. The voters created it when they, I think 2012, we created this entity known as South Sound 911. There are partner agencies throughout Pierce County. All of the public safety agencies make up the South Sound 911 agency. And we have an agreement with them with regards to our own services that we receive through South Sound 911. The county executive is a member of the board. The Pierce County Council has a representative that also is involved. And it was an opportunity for us, again, to meet their needs, because part of the arrangement when they were created was the idea that they were going to need a facility to operate out of. And so this allows us to help them in that regard, but also deal with the problems that we've had with the health department building itself.
So regarding South Sound 911, why not put them in the location of the old Pierce County Hospital?
That's a good question. So back in mid-2015, we started a site selection process for South Sound 911 after a site they previously identified was determined to be unfeasible due to high development cost. And so at that current time, there was another proposal on the old hospital site, which was for the General Services Building. That proposal did not move forward after a vote of the people. And since that time, we've taken a look at the hospital site and done some initial analysis, and we still feel that the health department site is a better site for the South Sound 911 facility for various reasons. One of them being that we feel the hospital site has a higher value and a higher development potential than a low-rise emergency operations center like South Sound 911. And another one is the project we are proposing solves multiple facility issues for multiple agencies. So it solves issues for the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department, Pierce County Community Connections, and South Sound 911. So we really feel that it's in the best interest of all those agencies to pursue the current proposal. And I will say we have a lot of work to do to ensure the current proposal is the most cost-effective for taxpayers, and it is feasible. And if that doesn't prove out, I think the hospital site could be a viable alternative for South Sound 911. But we really feel this is a better alternative than the hospital site.
I'm glad you brought up the General Services Building, because I think that's kind of an elephant in the room. Let's talk about the differences between that proposal and this one. Councilmember Talbert?
Sure. Again, that proposal would have brought, you know, 18 separate county functions all into one facility. It would have gotten the county out of 8 or 10 separate leased facilities that we were in. It would have consolidated all of those administrative services in one location, which would have resulted in efficiencies not only for the county services, but for citizens seeking those services. This proposal will only include one county department, which is Community Connections, along with the health department, and combining those functions, and again, as Travis mentioned, freeing up that space then for South Sound 911, which is a separate agency, to come in. The good thing is for the community itself, they were very excited about the potential that the General Services Building was going to bring to that community, and were quite disappointed when that didn't occur.
they are now equally excited about an opportunity to have South Sound 911 come in with more than 200 employees in that community every day. It's going to help with the revitalization that's already occurring in the Lincoln Business District. So the community itself is very excited about this opportunity. And if this moves forward, you know, they'll be taking down the old health department building, the building adjacent to it where our community connection folks are in, and the hospital, which again, that community is really excited about getting that building off of there because it's become an attractive nuisance for elements that really aren't, you know, in the neighborhood's best interest.
And Travis, were you at those community meetings as well?
Yes, yes.
So what were some of the concerns that Councilmember Talbert was talking about that you heard from the citizens?
I think one of the concerns that we talked about earlier was utilization of the old hospital site for South Sound 911. And another one is, why are we demolishing the health department building and Soundview buildings? And I think the simple answer to that has been, in our initial analysis, it proved to be more cost effective to demolish those buildings and build new structures than it would be to refurbish and repurpose those buildings for a new program. And so that's, we're going to do some deeper analysis during the next couple months to prove those out and come back. And we want to have another round of community meetings before we would take this project to the county council to explain our findings once we get through due diligence work. And that's where we really want to explain some of these things in a lot greater detail that we don't have right now. As we kind of said, it's been tough because this is a concept project, and so we don't have all the details figured out. But that's really what we're driving for the next couple months, is to figure out these details and come back and explain all those details to the community.
Will the citizens have a chance to vote on this project?
As it's constituted now, no. It would be an issue that would come before the county council. Last year's process became an issue of a referendum. I don't know whether this falls into that likelihood. That's for others to I guess, weigh in on. But, you know, again, this should be a decision that the county council and the county executive bringing forward to the council will make a decision. And I think we're hoping to have that potential early in the summer.
So what's the timeline going forward? What are our next steps?
So our next steps are really, like I said, is we're truly in the due diligence phase of this project, where we're analyzing this existing building across the street to make sure both programs can fit and fit comfortably in that building. And we're currently doing that, and we'll be doing that for the next couple months. We still need to finalize a purchase and sale agreement for the property across the street. We currently have a signed letter of intent with the property owner and are working on a draft of that agreement. We hope to have that finalized in May. After May, we expect to be complete with our due diligence work that will make sure we can confirm our budgets and our initial assumptions about the project are correct. And then we would be bringing the project to the county council for approval in July. If that project would be approved at that point, we would still need to finish some construction documentation and pull the tenant improvement permits. And I think we would be in a position to start construction about February 2017. And then that would put occupation of the facility about this time, April 2017, if everything went to plan. And thinking back to the South Sound 911 project, their timeline is really dictated on the council approval of the health and community building in July. So if the health and community building is approved, South Sound 911 can get going and proceed with pre-development design work. They still need to do a lot of design work to confirm what their facility is and how much it costs. So that times out well, because that's going to take them 7 to 8 months to do come July if the project is approved, and then they would be coming back to the county council and the South Sound 911 boards around February 2017-ish, getting approval to construct their facility.
So if I'm sitting at home and this is the first time I'm finding out about this, where can I go to find out more information? How do I stay on top of developments in this area?
Well, I think if you visit, we've created two project web pages, and I think one is piercecounty.org/HCB, and so that has all the information we have on the projects. So I encourage people to go there and sign up for a newsletter, and we will be issuing a monthly newsletter to give updates on the project, and we'll be advising when we have the next round of community meetings. So I strongly encourage everyone to visit those websites and sign up for the monthly newsletters and make sure they get a chance to attend the next round of community meetings that tentatively will be scheduled towards the end of June, first part of July.
Very good. We're going to stay on top of this. Thank you very much, Travis. Councilmember Talbert, appreciate you being here.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Coming up next, what's in it for South Sound 911 and the Health Department? Find out right after this.
Now you can see Pierce County from your phone or tablet with the new PCTV mobile app. Pierce County and City Council meetings, the weekly Pierce County News
on PCTV,
news magazine Rainier Country, the topical discussions of Pierce County Talks, and all of the special programs in between. Download the app today and see Pierce County from here. PCTV, Pierce County Television.
County leaders are exploring the idea of co-locating the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department with Community Connections, while also making a new home for South Sound 911. Before we hear from them, let's learn more about what came out of the first public meetings.
Public meetings have begun for Pierce County's proposed health and community building in Tacoma's Lincoln District.
When this opportunity came together, it was a chance to solve the health department's problems, do some consolidation with regards to community connections, get us out of leased facilities and into owned facilities, and then, as I said, also address the neighborhood issue with regards to the hospital.
The proposal is to combine the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections in an existing office building across the street. The county would finalize the purchase of that property in May.
We've discovered that there are some shared resources and the work that we do complement each other, so we truly believe that this is a wonderful concept to explore.
We're really excited about the possibility of partnering with Pierce County Community Connections. We think that this is a fabulous step for customers who live in Pierce County.
If the health and community building gets the green light, South Sound 911 wants to construct a two-building campus where the health department currently sits. The organization handles more than 2,000 911 calls a day for 41 police and fire agencies. The site on Pacific Avenue is one of the only few in the county that meets strict standards.
We will have two separate buildings co-located. One will be about a 55,000 square foot emergency operations and public safety communications center that will meet all those stringent requirements. And basically what the requirements lead up to is the fact that if there's a major earthquake or disaster, our building needs to be the last one standing.
Pierce County would demolish the old Puget Sound Hospital, plus the current health department and Soundview buildings. Because of factors like asbestos and HVAC, the numbers show remodeling those buildings is more expensive than building new.
A few more public meetings are scheduled for May, and the county plans to hold more public meetings later in the process if the proposal moves forward. Joining me now is Andrew Neiditz, Executive Director of South Sound 911, and Nancy Sutton, Deputy Director of the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department. Thank you both for being here.
Thank you.
So tell me, why does it make sense to have Community Connections and the Health Department in the same building?
Well, the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections have collaborated for a long time to serve residents of Pierce County, and it makes sense to co-locate us to provide more convenient service for residents of the county. Our services complement each other but don't duplicate each other, and we do serve complicated folks who have a lot of support needs.
Where is Pierce County, the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department now, and why can't they just stay there?
We're in a 40-year-old building on Pacific Avenue at the corner of South 37th Street. The building has seen better days and needs significant rehabilitation. We've also outgrown it. We have staff in three floors of a building that's kitty-cornered across Pacific Avenue from our building. The building was constructed to deliver clinic services. It's also the home of the former county morgue. And so we have purchasing and receiving operating out of the old morgue facilities. And it was set up to deliver a type of public health service that we don't deliver anymore. We work with networks of physicians in the community to deliver vaccines and to help travelers who need shots before they go out of the country. And instead, we provide teaming, monitoring, support, assessment, the kinds of services that you don't deliver in a clinic.
And Andrew, why is the site good for South Sound 911?
Well, we have actually evaluated about 30 sites around the Tacoma-Pierce County area, and this one meets our criteria in terms of a whole series of very stringent security requirements, in terms of distance from hazards and proximity to our larger departments that we serve. We can't be in a floodplain. We can't be in a Lahar zone. We have to build a building that is standing when everything else is not, because of the nature of what we do. And so this site does meet our needs. And the fact that it's owned by Pierce County, and the county is one of our six owners, if you will, in terms of our interlocal agreement, makes it expedient for this to be county-owned and to meet our needs at the same time.
Tell me more about the building itself. What kind of complex do you want to build?
We're actually building what we call a campus, because we're planning for two buildings. One will be a very high security essential facility type of structure that will house a police and fire dispatch center, as well as a municipal emergency operations center. And security, for the reasons I mentioned before, is very critically important for that. And the cost of construction is quite high. We're going to build a second building, a somewhat smaller building, for the support staff, for the record staff, for the IT people, and for the admin people, of about 25,000 square feet, to be located next to the larger building, which will be about 55,000 square feet. So it will be a campus of about 85,000 square feet in two buildings, and the purpose of the two buildings really is to cut down on the cost.
Speaking of cost, Nancy, what's the ballpark figure that we're looking at here?
Well, this is a concept proposal, so it's being studied right now to determine whether or not Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections will even fit into the building that is being considered, which is at 3615 Pacific Avenue. So the sale price and the cost per footage will be determined a little farther down the road once we know whether or not the programs will actually fit in the buildings.
Assuming everything does fit and the program works out, where does the money come from?
Well, in our case, the money comes from a voter-approved ballot measure from November of 2011, whereby the voters approved a 25-year sales tax increase specifically to provide for equipment and facilities to create a public safety interoperability system, which we've never had.
And you mentioned that's your scenario. Is that the same for you as well?
No, for the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections, the county would issue a bond and would purchase the building, and we would become tenants in that arrangement and would pay back the county's bond.
You both were present for the public meetings that have been held all around the county. Tell me some of the things that you heard from the community.
Well, I guess I'll speak first for the neighbors. The Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department has been in the neighborhood we're at for 40 years, and we do know the neighbors, and we talk with them. Their primary concern was to see the old public health Puget Sound Hospital, to have that hospital building torn down. It's an eyesore in the neighborhood and a focus for crime. They're very concerned about that. They're also concerned that the community, not the neighborhood, not be left with other vacant buildings. So the neighbors like the idea that this proposal takes care of one derelict hospital and two older, shabby office buildings, has the health department and community connections moving into a large building that's currently vacant, and then does create new state-of-the-art buildings for the two buildings. So that's some of the feedback we've heard from the neighbors.
Andrew, what's some of the things you've heard?
Well, I think the comments I've heard, the ones that are not supportive, fall into two categories. One is a general concern about cost. The question has been raised, are we building a Taj Mahal? And the answer is no, we're not. We're actually building a very cost-effective project that is based on a considerably lower cost than what was envisioned a few years ago. And the second series of concerns has to do with location, where people have questioned why are we close in to Tacoma and why are we not further out where perhaps the cost would be less. And the answer to that question really has to do with the 41 police and fire departments we serve, and the larger ones are close in, and so it is the strong desire of those agencies to have their support center located in a place that is accessible for them and for the staff that work there.
And ultimately, whatever the cost, the benefits will be to the people of Pierce County. Tell me about some of those. How are they going to benefit?
Well, in the case of Southside 911, the benefits, I think, are tremendous, because for the first time ever, we will have police, fire, and medical dispatch housed in a co-located fashion in one place. We started out with six separate 911 centers around the county. People want their police and fire agencies to be able to work in a coordinated way, and most importantly, people want to have the fastest response to an emergency situation when they call 911. And this building will be a major step forward for us to accomplish that.
And what about for the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department?
Well, I think one of the benefits for the residents of the county is that Pierce County Community Connections moves out of some leased space that they have downtown that they're paying about $500,000 a year for, as I understand. And it will co-locate the Community Connections with the Health Department, and we will be able to better serve those families that we're already both engaged with doing different kind of work. It will be more convenient for people who are trying to get services from both organizations.
This is a complex proposal with a lot of moving parts. What does the timeline look like between now and when this project is complete?
Well, there are actually two separate timelines because of the two separate funding sources and two separate targeted completion dates. In the case of South Sound 911, we have a narrow window for this funding that was approved, so we really need to move as quickly as we can to start construction. The goal would be to start construction in 2017 and actually complete this by the very beginning of 2019.
So for the other project, the timeline right now, the project managers for the county are working with some designers and with the potential building owners to assess whether or not the Tacoma-Pierce County Health Department and Pierce County Community Connections will both fit in the building. That's the first threshold. Will we fit? What are the costs associated with that? Is it an affordable package? And does it save money? Does it make sense over the course of time? There will be some votes that happen of the Board of Health will vote and consider, and then the County Council will consider this. I believe they're trying to get it on their agenda for July. If it's approved by both bodies and if the project gets a green light, I believe they're looking to get started this summer and are hopeful that potentially a year from now, Community Connections and the Health Department could be moved into a new facility.
And what happens if the proposal fails or is met with resistance? Is there a backup plan?
Well, from the perspective of the Health Department, you know, we've been deferring significant renovations to our facility for a long time. Our assessment is that it's not very cost effective for us to simply renovate the building that we're in. It's in such a condition that we would actually have to move out in order to really renovate that building. And so you end up incurring lease and moving costs that add to the cost of the project. But that's the path that we would proceed down, is trying to accumulate funding and working with the county to fund a project that we think could end up being more expensive.
And what about South Sound 911?
If this doesn't work, we would have no choice but to find another 5-acre site that meets our criteria. And it would probably be a privately owned site, and it would probably be more expensive and take more time to do.
Well, thank you very much for being here today. I hope you keep us posted on how this thing develops.
Thank you.
Thank you, Eric.
That wraps up this edition of Pierce County Talks. You can watch this program online anytime or on our mobile app, available at piercecountytv.org. I'm Eric Ebel. Thanks for watching.